Welcome to A Magical Life, Health, Wealth and Weight Loss. I'm your host, Magic Barclay, lead practitioner at Holistic Natural Health Australia and number one best-selling author. In this podcast, I aim to give you practical tips on how to accelerate and sustain your health, increase your financial, spiritual and emotional wealth, and to look at something that haunts many of us needlessly, weight loss. In some episodes, I'll have guests available to give you even more tips, but in others, the floor is yours. Drop us a line at A Magical Life Podcast on Facebook and let me know what you would like to know more about. Now, sit back and enjoy, because it is time for you to create and truly discover a magical life. Welcome back to A Magical Life. I'm your host, Magic Barclay, and today I'm joined by Ann Hince. When Ann was 19, she woke one morning to find her mother dead in her bathroom. 20 years later, the tears from that trauma were still just under the surface. Ann found a simple technique that helped her release these emotions, but she went further, can now put her awareness inside her body, has changed the bone structure of her skull and grown half an inch at age 55. Ann has found that seeking out our truth, what we truly feel, and accepting those feelings is the key to inner peace. Welcome, Ann.
Thank you. It's lovely to be here.
Thanks for joining me. Now, look, you know, that's a really traumatic thing at 19. So how did that all evolve? What happened?
She had cancer, and we had been told 6 months prior that she had cancer and it was terminal, but she wasn't supposed to die that night. You know, she actually had tumors in her throat. She had lung and throat cancer from drinking a lot. She would drink a bottle of sherry a day during those last years and smoking continuously. So one of the tumors in her throat burst that night. And so I woke up and found her there. So yeah, that's how that happened.
Wow. So that's a really life-changing moment in time. So what did you do once that happened? Like, you've said that you found a simple technique. How did you find that? How did you go on your journey?
Yeah, well, that was a long time later. So after my mother died, I didn't know what to do. I didn't even know there was anything else you could do other than just go on with life, because that's what we did. That was the water that I swam in childhood. We never talked about emotions or feelings. We just went on with life. So I just continued on with life. And it wasn't until I was in my late 30s. I had two young boys. I was a stay-at-home mother. And I had like a business altercation with a couple of other mothers at school. They thought it was the wrong decision that I had made, but it wasn't. It was fine. But they were really strong, confident, self-assured women, and I was not. And my mind just spun around and around and around, and I couldn't let go of the words they used and the feelings that I was having. I couldn't sleep for days. And that was the first time that I realized that maybe it was something from my childhood, because they reminded me of my dad. It was what I would do when my dad would get angry with me. I would kind of shrink inside and I'd go over it in my mind. So, well, maybe there's something from my childhood I haven't looked at this point. So it was around this time frame that I actually went to a doctor's appointment, and he was a holistic physician, and he recognized that I was more stressed than I should be. And he asked me on a scale of 0 through 10 how stressed I was. And I said it was an 8 out of 10. And then he asked me why. And I knew straight away that it was finding my mother, which is now two decades earlier, because the tears were still just under the surface. There was so much energy around it still stored inside of me that hadn't been dealt with. So that's when he used this technique with me. It's called EFT, which is short for emotional freedom technique. And it's also called tapping. So he tapped with me for about 15 minutes about finding her that morning. And I walked away from that appointment being able to tell the story in my mind without the tears. They had gone. So to me, that was just a huge shift that was really amazing at the time.
EFT certainly is an amazing tool, and I know you're going to bring it up when I ask the three questions that I ask all of my fabulous guests. So let's get into it. And the first one is, what can your expertise do to accelerate health, be it physical, emotional, or spiritual?
Ah, well, all of those are connected. And that is what I have found along my path, is that it's really emotional health and physical health and spiritual health are really one and the same thing. And all this work, all the different couple of different techniques that I used along the journey, they're all releasing the emotional charge that is stored physically in the body. And because it's stored physically in the body, it's also affecting the physical health. And when we let go of tension stored in the body or dis-ease in the body, it is releasing the bonds that hold our ego in place. And therefore, when we release that, we are also affecting our spiritual health. Because once we release that tension, we can actually tune into spirit more easily.
It certainly is amazing how much EFT opens up your world. Now, look, we talk about wealth here as well. So it's not just the financial, but the emotional wealth that you can have, the spiritual wealth that you can have, that kind of personal growth. So what are your top three tips to creating wealth?
Well, my three tips would kind of always be to move along this path. And the first thing is to notice when we become emotional. And that in itself is not easy to do because we get caught up in our emotions. So the first thing would to be watch yourself during the day and see if you can notice, oh, I'm becoming emotional, or I feel some feelings. And once you've done that, then you can do something about it. So the next thing to do would be something like even taking a deep breath is going to release some tension. Not necessarily at a deep level, but if you learn EFT, right, which I would highly recommend, well, maybe that would be the second thing that I would recommend, is learning EFT. It's very easy to learn. You can actually learn it in 5 minutes, and there are thousands of videos online that you can learn from. And so if you're feeling emotional, if you tap those emotions out with EFT, you're actually changing your physical signal in the moment. And therefore, you're changing your future. So that is something else you can do. Then at a deeper level, so it would be more the empaths have a deeper awareness already. They can normally feel the physical sensations underneath the emotions. So if you have that capability already, then you can use the feeling your feelings. You can actually start feeling those sensations and releasing them. And it takes a little work to practice doing that. I do have a video on my YouTube channel that walks you through that process, but that releases both the emotions and the physical and allows relaxation. And when you're relaxed, that's the signal you're emitting, and that's what you're going to attract back into your life in the future. So hopefully those three will help someone.
They're great tips, actually. Thank you. And we talk about weight loss here as well. Many people struggle with this, and I know EFT can help with weight loss, but have you had a personal journey with weight loss or weight gain, and how did you combat that?
Yeah, that's an interesting question. I haven't used EFT so much for weight loss or weight gain. What I have used it for, and this kind of works along with the wealth, if people looking for financial wealth too, is actually letting go of the resistance or the thoughts and beliefs around food. Right. So I have tried to control my diet many times before EFT mostly. I've tried all sorts of things, but nothing really stuck. It wasn't until I got to EFT that actually I found something that worked permanently. So with EFT, what I would do is I would tap about a fear of eating something or a fear. Mostly I worked with around the food, but if there's feelings around being a certain weight right now, there can be negative feelings. The thing about EFT is it works so well with negative. So I know people want to go positive these days, but really it's only the negative that's stored in the body. So we really only have to work on the negative, and that's what EFT does. So if you weren't feeling good about your current physical state, that's what you would tap on. You would tap on, you know, I hate the way I look, and that's okay. You'd actually tap to allow the feelings around those words to dissipate so that you could say those words, right? I hate the way I hate my size, whatever. And it has no emotional charge, no energetic charge to it anymore. There's a relaxation in it. And the more you do that, the more you're kind of putting off a vibration. You're putting off a signal in every moment. We're emitting a signal and we're attracting back to us based on that. So if we let go of the emotional charge around how we feel about our physical self, then what we're attracting back into the future is different. And that's when change happens. And it's amazing to actually see it happen and feel it happen, but you actually have to experience it yourself to really understand how it works that way.
I couldn't agree more. As someone who's battled with weight pretty much all my life and been at every end of the spectrum, from super morbidly obese to anorexic, really detaching myself from the physical shell or the casing that I see in the mirror and not making that an emotional attachment, not saying, well, that's me, but more saying that's just the vessel that holds me at the moment. That was a big learning for me and a big shift to finally, as you said, detach and just go, well, okay, this is who I am on the inside. That's what I look like on the outside, but that's going to change. So, you know, that was a really big learning for me.
Nice. And that's a full acceptance, right? And I had to go down, you know, I went down all the path of all the beliefs that I could think of from childhood. And I got down to the place of actually tapping on the phrase, I hate myself. And I tapped on myself for hours using that phrase until that phrase no longer had any power over me. It's just words. I can say I hate myself and it doesn't mean anything, you know, but other people who are attached to those words would say, oh, you shouldn't say that, right? Don't say that. That's not a good thing to say. But when it has no charge to it, you can say it and it doesn't mean anything anymore. It's not a signal inside of me and it's not attracting things to me in the future that make me feel like I hate myself anymore.
Exactly. And having that charge attached to a phrase also changes your energetic frequency. So I've spoken to people on the podcast before about frequencies of illness. And so when you start to attach to the energy of a phrase, like I hate myself or I'm not worthy or whatever it might be, you're actually inviting something of a similar frequency, which could be a pathogen. It could be a disease state. It could be, well, anything that contributes to a disease state, because that has that same negative frequency. And I think so many people don't actually realize that that's the case.
Yeah. I mean, everything has a frequency. I mean, if you think about it, think about the word COVID these days, right? The word COVID, in each of us, it has a different feeling inside of us based on how we've gone through the last couple of years. So that word itself has history inside of us that it's part of our signal. And we're emitting that and we're attracting that based on our future. And so if we release any charge around the word COVID, so it's just the word, doesn't mean anything to us, it has no emotional feelings inside of us, then it's not attracting back into our future anything like the same thing. Whereas, you know, there are people out there and you say the word COVID and they will cringe, right? And you know, and for them, that word has a huge emotional component to it. And that's the signal that they're emitting when they think of that word or hear that word. So the freedom is in releasing the attachments to all of those words and the phrases and the beliefs and the trauma we've had. But to get there, to actually release it, we have to accept it. And once we accept it, once we focus on it, hold our awareness on it and just accept it, that's when it releases. And that's what I found in this path that I've gone through.
Agreed. I mean, that's just such a big thing. Now, look, I do have to go back to your bio here for a minute. And you changed your bone structure of your skull and grew. How did that happen?
Well, that was moving deeper into the body. So that, you know, that's part of my story. It's like I went deeper and deeper. My awareness got deeper and deeper into my body so that I could actually feel inside my body, feel through the connective tissue and release tension at the deepest level. So I could release tension inside the connective tissue in my face and my muscles, and now in my bones. So I could actually feel the bones relax into a more relaxed place. I didn't know at the time what I was doing was relaxing into a more aligned position, which is what the x-rays show. So I have x-rays from 2013, and they're just orthodontic x-rays. And then again last year, and comparing them, actually seeing them for myself, seeing them in person was just amazing, because I knew things were happening on the inside. I could feel them, but actually to see the changes, I didn't even know eye sockets could move. But my eye sockets have aligned, and my jaw, which was way off to the side, is now much more in the center. And my neck, I have scoliosis. I think I've had it from birth, and that is straightening out. So my whole body is unwinding. And I think that's why I have grown, because my neck is straightening out. All the tension that was stored in it is releasing, and it's straightening. But it's just been this journey. It started out with EFT and working on my childhood traumas, and then just going deeper and deeper into the body.
Fantastic. Now, you also have a book, A Pathway to Insight, and people can find that on amazon.com/pathwayinsightrecaptureyourchildhood. And people can find you on annhince.com. You're on Facebook at Ann Hince Wisdom. And you also have a YouTube channel. I would love to talk to you more about this fantastic book. So in 128, let's dive deep into your pathway to insight. How does that sound?
That sounds great.
Terrific. Listeners, thank you so much for your time. This was your episode 127 in 128. And we'll talk to us more about pathway to insight. For now, listeners, go forth and create your magical life. Thanks for listening today. Please subscribe to hear future episodes, leave a review, and share this podcast. You can follow us on Facebook at A Magical Life Podcast or at Holistic Natural Health Australia. That's holistic with a W. You can find us on Instagram at Holistic Natural Health or at www.holisticnaturalhealth.com.au. That's where you'll access all sorts of articles, freebies, and more.